Hi, I have already explained you how to create a project in MPLAB X and write a code to blink LED connected to RB0. In this lecture, I will explain you the different registers associated with GPIO pins and then we'll analyze the code generated by MCC. First, let us open the datasheet of PIC 16F18877 and navigate to chapter 12 in page number 200. The device we are using has 5 ports named as port A, port B, C, D, and port E. If you check the pin diagram, the pins named as RA0, RA1, RA2 till RA7 are grouped as port A. Port B consists of pins RB0, RB1, RB2 till RB7. Pins RC0, RC1 till RC7 belongs to port C. Port D has RD0, RD1 till RD7. Whereas port E has only 4 pins, RE0, RE1, RE2 and RE3. The pin RE3 is assigned with master clear function. In total, there are 36 GPIO pins in this 40-pin package used in evaluation board. Most port pins share common functions with device peripherals, both analog and digital. In general, when a peripheral is enabled on a port pin, that pin cannot be used as a general purpose output. Each of these ports have many registers like port, latch, TRIS, analog select, weak pull-up, input level, slew rate control, and open drain control. Here, X refers the corresponding port name. For example, port A, TRIS A, LAT A, etc. are the registers assigned for port A. To understand how the port works, have a look at the port structure. Whenever a data is written to either port or LAT register, the data is held in the data register. If the tri-state buffer is enabled by writing a logic 0 to the TRIS register, the data will be assigned to the particular pin of the port. If the tri-state buffer is enabled by writing a logic 0 to TRIS register, the data will be assigned to the particular pin of the port. A write to port register will cause a special problem of read modify write. Latch register is used to overcome this read modify write problem in PIC. But when you want to read a port, you should read it from port register, because a read from latch gives the value of the data register, whereas read from port register gives you the actual value of the port pin. But you should disable TRIS register when reading to prevent the value of data register from overwriting the value of the port pin. The register analog select allows a port pin to be used from an analog to digital converter. If you want to use a pin for digital input output, then you must disable the corresponding bit in the analog select register. This is important. If analog select bit is not cleared, then the AND gate will block the read operation. You must remember that when you want to write to a port, use latch register instead of port register. These diodes connected between VDD, ground and port pin provides over voltage and polarity protection. If any high voltage or negative voltage appears on the pin, these diodes conduct, thereby limiting the voltage on a pin. Port A registers. As I have already said, there are registers for each and every port. TRIS A register controls the direction of the port A. Setting a TRIS A bit is equal to 1 will make the corresponding port A pin an input. That means it disables the output driver. Clearing a TRIS A bit will make the corresponding port A pin an output. There are two possible connections for every pin in PIC: open drain and push pull. Open drain operation is independently selected for each pin. When an open drain control bit is set, the corresponding port output becomes an open drain driver capable of sinking current only. In this case, a pull-up resistor is connected to drive any load. When an open drain control bit is cleared, the corresponding port output pin is the standard push-pull drive capable of sourcing and sinking current. In addition, each port has a slew rate control register which allows the user to control the rate at which signal changes. When a slew rate controlled bit is set, the corresponding port pin drive is slew rate limited. Slew rate is nothing but the rate of change of signal with respect to time. The input level register controls the input voltage threshold for each of the available port input pins. The analog select bits default to the analog mode after reset. To use any pins as digital general purpose or peripheral inputs, the corresponding analog select bits must be initialized to zero by user software. Weak pull-up register allows us to enable internal pull-ups for port A pins. These are the summary of registers for port A. These are for port B, for port C, port D, and these are for port E. Now we'll open the code generated by MCC and analyze it. First, open the main.c file in the source file. The file has a header file named mcc.h in the MCC generated files directory. To check the header file, select the header files, MCC generated files, and open this mcc.h file. It has few header files included, like xc.h for x8 compiler, pinmanager.h, and then few standard library files. It has definition of crystal frequency of 1 MHz. There are two function declarations. One is system initialize and the other one is oscillator initialize. Definition of these two functions can be found under source files in mcc.c file. At the beginning, there are pragma preprocessor statements used to configure bits. All the config registers, config1, config2, config3, 4, and config 5 register bits are set to default values by the IDE. This is the function system initialize, which does two functions. It initializes the port as either input or output. Since we have set RB0 as output, you should expect the least significant bit of TRISB register set as 0. To check that, just right click on the pin manager initialize and select navigate and then go to declaration. It opens pinmanager.c file where that function is implemented. So the function has set all latch registers of all ports to 0. Here check the TRIS registers. All port pins are made input by writing a bit 1 to their positions. These registers are 8-bit registers, so when all the bits are set to 1, it becomes FF in hexadecimal. To make RB0 as output, you need to set LSB of TRISB to 0. That means except the last bit, all other bits must be set to 1. That gives a value of FE in hexadecimal. MCC disables the output drivers of the remaining pins by writing bit 1 to corresponding bits of TRIS register. Port E has only 4 pins, out of which RE3 pin is used as master clear. That leaves us with 3 pins on port E. All of them are not used. So MCC makes it as input pin by writing 07 to make RE0, RE1 and RE2 as input pins. Now RB0 is used as digital I/O pins. So the LSB of analog select B register is set to 0 to enable read. Weak pull-ups and open drain registers are cleared by writing 0. That makes all internal pull-ups disabled and the pins operate on push-pull mode, not on open drain mode. In push-pull mode, the pin is capable of both sinking and sourcing currents. Come back to mcc.c. Second function is oscillator initialize function, which writes values to oscillator control registers to set internal oscillator, oscillator frequency and other oscillator related options. Now open pinmanager.h file in the header files. At the top, there are few definitions for input, output, high, low, and few other. you should never change these header file contents. Check red LED set high definition in line 69. This line sets the bit corresponding to RB0, that is LSB of LATB register, as 1. That means it drives the pin RB0 high. Similarly, the line red LED set low sets RB0 pin low. Red LED toggle line actually reads the least bit of LATB register and inverts it. The tilde sign is a complement operator, that means it inverts the bit. There are few more definitions which we don't require now. Now come back to main function to see the code. There is a system initialize function call to set RB0 as output and to initialize oscillator control registers. Inside the while loop, we have continuously toggled the RB0 pin with a delay of 500 milliseconds. So the LED will blink every second. That's it. You learned about different registers associated with GPIO pins, how ports can be assigned input or output functionality. We also analyzed the code generated by MPLAB Code Configurator. Now, to check how much you have studied in this section, there are a few interesting assignments. Try to solve them by your own. All the best. Take care.